Alert is a 6 ounce white and red soda pop bottle on green glass, and it comes to us from Iron Mountain, Michigan. This is the only variation known so far. A Madden's comes from Coldwater, Michigan. The middle one is a 7 ounce bottle. The other two are 8 ounce bottles. These are the only three variations known. They weren't known to us till about a year ago, when somebody from Indiana sent me three of them in the mail. They're not real common, but they're not worth a whole lot, because they're a pretty plain label. Americola comes from Detroit, from Carbonated Beverages. It was bottled up on the east side. The one that has a real bad label, which is red, white, and blue, is a real scarce variation. There aren't that many of them known. I'm lucky to have the one I do. The white label only, that still has its contents in it, is real common. There's cases of them floating around. The Arolas come from Marquette and Republic. Both names are on the back of the bottle. The green and white label is a little bit scarcer, but it doesn't make it worth any more. And the red and cream is a real common one. These were sent to me by a man up north in the Upper Peninsula. Atlas bottles usually range in between 6 and 12 ounce bottles. Atlas has been in business for several years, so they have many different style bottles, as you can see. This is only about half of them. The only Atlas bottle that I'm really missing is a black and orange label, which is very scarce. There's only one of them known so far that have been collected up, and it's in somebody's collection, and they won't part with it, so. Atomic Cola comes to us from Detroit, from the Atomic Cola Company, and this is a pretty scarce bottle to get. Now, there's another variation to this bottle that actually has an atomic, like, bomb cloud on it, and that's the harder one of the two. Now, this is an unusual specimen, Ari's Cola. It comes from the Ari's Bread Company in Detroit. I was the first one to get one of these, and then a few other people got one a few months later. They start popping out of the woodwork, but it's definitely an unusual one. Barg's comes to us from Battle Creek. They also had it bottled in Grand Rapids by the Verner's Company. This is a fairly common bottle. This is Wolverine's Big Five Beverages. It's a 12 ounce bottle. It comes from Detroit by the Wolverine Ginger Ale Company. Big Joe is a 16 ounce bottle. I've also seen it in a 7 ounce bottle. It comes out of Detroit, but from which bottler I'm unsure of because it's not marked. Bingo comes from Farmington, and it's an 8 ounce red and yellow label on green glass. This is not a beverage bottle. This is actually like a champagne or a wine cooler. It comes from that old distillery that's up on Orchard Lake Road in Farmington. Grand River, I'm sorry. Barley's comes to us from Detroit. I believe it was bottled by White Rock or Canada Dry in Highland Park. It's a real common bottle, and this one happens to have its original contents. Black Cow comes from Saginaw, Michigan. It's a 12 ounce bottle. This one's kind of sought after because it's two color on an amber glass, and it's kind of neat, really. It's sort of scarce. Blossom Land comes from St. Joseph, Michigan. It's a fairly common bottle, but it's kind of neat. Bobby Sox is a nice beverage. It comes from Ludington, Michigan, and it's blue and white on a 7-ounce bottle. Kind of neat. Brownies come from Atlas Beverages, and there's just two variations known. The one with the red neck label and the one with the white neck label, and that's the only difference. They're fairly common bottles, but usually they're all beat up and chipped up. I happen to get these in fairly decent shape, so they're worth just a little more, but not much. These are the famous Bulldog Ginger Ales, or Ginger Beers, excuse me, from Detroit. The one on your left is from the original company, which was the Bulldog Ginger Beer Company. The one in the middle was from Wolverine, which bought that company out. And then finally it ended up with Atlas. And you can see they really never changed the label on the bottle. They changed on the back, and I'll show you. Buster Cola comes from Detroit, and it's kind of a neat bottle because it's got a weird color combination, yellow and red, and it comes from Grilly's Brothers in Detroit. It's a 12-ounce bottle. It's kind of big with the cola collector, you know, only because it says cola. This is a neat one. It comes from Cadillac Beverage Company in Detroit. It was believed to be up on the west side. It's a 12-ounce bottle. It's pretty hot with the Michigan collectors because it's got the Cadillac emblem on it. And it's kind of a scarce bottle. Canada Dry comes to us from Highland Park, Detroit, Grand Rapids, Lansing. There's tons of different variations to all the different Canada Dry bottles. So I'm just showing the one that I have with the original contents in it. But I do have others. Capri is a pretty unusual bottle. It's believed to be bottled by Faygo in Detroit, but though it's not marked and it's not listed in the base book as being bottled by anybody. Champ was bottled by Red Arrow and then later by Stempion in Detroit, and it's just a nothing bottle. Chapman's Beverages were bottled in Saginaw, Michigan. As you can see, they've got quite a few variations. I don't believe I have them all, but if I lived up in Saginaw, I bet you I could get them all, and they're fairly common. Cheer Ups were bottled by Ellis Bottling in Detroit, and you can see they have three different front labels, which probably means that each time that they had a new generation made up, they changed the label, and they're fairly common. Circus was bottled in Mount Clemens by the Nesbitt Bottling Company. Now this is a pretty sought after bottle because it's got a picture of a clown on it, and it does have a real nice picture to it. Clico Club comes from Iron Mountain, Grayling, and Saginaw. They're real common, so they're not really worth much. I got three different variations, too, which have the original contents in them still. These are just a few of the Coca-Cola bottles. They have them from every major city in Michigan and some of the minors. Crush bottles are fairly common, except for the variety on the left, which is amber. That's kind of a rare one, and so is the green one. They were bottled in most major cities. What I've got here are from Grayling, Detroit, Marquette, and Grand Rapids. These are the older two. Crystal Falls comes from, of course, Crystal Falls, Michigan. It's a fairly common bottle. There's also another variety with a green label, green glass. Dad's comes from mostly all major cities. The one I have with the original contents is from Detroit, and the other one is from Ann Arbor. They're fairly common bottles. They also had them in amber with the same color labels. Deacon Jones comes to us from Mount Clemens from the Nesbitt Bottling Company. This is a real sought-after bottle. It's got red, white, and blue label. Mine's in very rough shape. I was lucky even to get this. Real scarce, and it's quite valuable. The nice thing about this hobby is you can always upgrade to a better bottle. This Diet Right comes to us from Verner's in Detroit. This is a scarce variation of the two. The other one is a clear glass, and this one's a green glass. It's a 16-ounce bottle. Delight for Two comes from the Wayne Carbonated Beverage Company in Detroit. It's a real scarce bottle. It's one of the first ACLs that came out of Detroit. Dawson comes to us from Detroit, Grand Rapids, Flint, Lansing. Dawson's originally had the whole bottling franchise for Pepsi for the whole state of Michigan. This Double Cola comes to us from Fago Beverages in Detroit and is, I'd say, a sort of a scarce variation in Detroit area. It might not be in other parts of the states. It's got a real interesting back label, and I'll show it to you. It says that it's been decocainized, which means it was made just after they outlawed cocaine. Dr. Pepper was bottled all over Michigan by different bottlers and came in various sizes. Dr. Wells comes from Grand Rapids, Muskegon, and Grayling. They're 7-ounce bottle, red and white label. And the ones that says makes a nickel thirsty are the older ones. They're a fairly common bottle, but hard to find in mint condition. Dumac comes to us from the Dumac Beverage Company in West Branch, Michigan. It's a 7-ounce bottle, red and white label. This bottle comes to us from Jackson, Michigan. It's a 7-ounce bottle with a white label, and it's real common and worth about nothing. Ellison's were generally 7-ounce bottles, and there's quite a few varieties. I've only had three here because they're from the Upper Peninsula, and I don't know many people up there to get them for me. Fanta comes to us from the Coca-Cola Bottling Company, and it was bottled in all major cities. Fago was originally called Fagason Brothers Bottling, and they were bottled on Gratiot. The original plant sat on 94 in Gratiot, which has been torn down because of the freeway, and then they later moved to the old Coca-Cola bottling plant, which was about 3 miles south on Gratiot. These are a few variations. The next scene I'll show you some more. Fontenelle comes from Grayling, Michigan.
from the Grayling Bottling Company. And this bottle is pretty much sought after highly across the United States because of the picture of the mermaid. I have a bunch of Frosties here. Most of them are from Detroit, but the one with just a plain cream color label comes from Ferndale. And the other few are from Atlas Bottling Works in Detroit. Fruit Bowl comes to us, one from Stempion in Detroit, one comes from Sturgis Bottling in Sturgis, Michigan. Globes come to us from Globe Bottling Works in Detroit on the red and white labels, 7-ounce bottles. Goody comes to us from Kalvia, Michigan, and it's a yellow and white label, 12-ounce bottle. Green River comes to us from Iron Mountain, Michigan. It's a 7-ounce bottle, and as you can see, it's kind of got a bluish liquid in it, and that's the original contents. What it tastes like, nobody knows. Probably enough to make you puke. These are Gorillas Bottling Works bottles, and they're from Detroit, Michigan. Gorillas is still in business, but they don't use bottles anymore. They just make syrup for the bars. This has got to be one of the plainest bottles there are in Michigan. Hancock Bottling Company from Hancock, Michigan. It's worth about a nickel, and it's real common. Harrison's is a pretty bottle, red, white, and blue label, and it's from Caspian, Michigan, and it's not really a common bottle from Michigan. Hep comes to us from the Red Rock Bottling Company in Bay City, Michigan. It's a fairly common bottle with a red and white label. High Class comes to us from Lansing, Michigan, and there are several variations, some of which have jumbo elephants on them, which I do not have in my collection as of this point. Hillsdale comes to us from Hillsdale, Michigan. Blue and white label, 7-ounce bottle. And it's fairly common. Hires came from every major city in Michigan by different bottlers. They could have had 2-3 bottlers of the brand in one city. Hollywood comes to us from Carroll Beverage Company in Bay City, Michigan, and it's fairly common. Hodge comes from Owosso, Michigan, and it is a common bottle, only worth a few dollars a bottle. Howell's Root Beer comes to us from Grayling, Petoskey, and Hancock, Michigan. Hunter's is a yellow and red label. It comes from us from Williamston, Michigan, and it's in a 10-ounce bottle. Carr's comes from the John Carr Bottling Company in Detroit, Michigan, or Del Rey. And it's a 7-ounce bottle, blue label, and it's fairly common. Castine's comes to us from Sagatuck, Michigan, and they're 7-ounce bottles. And there's only 2 variations known. Ionia comes from Ionia, Michigan, and it was bottled by the Coca-Cola Bottling Company. Kern's comes to us from Port Huron, Michigan, and was bottled by the Fred Kern Bottling Company. Kist is a fairly common bottle. Comes from Dowagiac, Sagatuck, Iron Mountain, and Republic, Michigan. Kool-Aid is a fairly common bottle. It comes to us from Lansing and Kalamazoo, Michigan. Lax comes to us from Muskegon, Michigan, and is a fairly common bottle. Land O'Lakes comes from Paris, Michigan, and it's priced decently, and it's a nice bottle. The Lemon Up comes to us from Gillis Bottling Company, and it's a rare bottle. There's only two of them known, and there's both of them are two different variations. As you can see here, mine has a picture of the bottle in the bottle, and the other one just says Lemon Up on it. Low Neck comes from Dowagiac Bottling Company in Dowagiac, Michigan, and every bottle known is cracked or the label's in poor condition, but it's a nothing bottle, so nobody really cares. M&S comes from Bay City in Flint. As you can see, there's many variations to this bottle. McFuddy's comes from Flint and Detroit. There's a McFuddy's Flint, there's a McFuddy's Detroit, and there's a Panacea Detroit. The Panacea is the harder one out of Detroit to get. Marquette is a 7-ounce bottle from Marquette, Michigan. As you can see, Mason's Root Beer came in a variety of different bottles and different sizes. So far in Michigan, we have listed from Flint, Adrian, Grand Rapids, Dowagiac, Detroit, Benton Harbor, Saginaw. Those are the known cities so far. Matson's is a 7-ounce pop bottle from Hancock, Michigan. And as you can see, I have two different varieties and labels, one of which my cat knocked over and broke. So I can always get another one. Fortunately, it's not a real expensive bottle. Mellow Blend comes from Port Huron, Michigan, from the 7-Up Bottling Works. It's a 7-ounce bottle. It's a maroon and yellow label, and it's fairly common. Mission Beverages comes to us from around the state. So far listed, we have Sault Ste. Marie, Sheboygan, Calvilla, Detroit, Grayling, Saginaw, Ferndale, Grand Rapids, Kalamazoo, Jackson, and it's a real common bottle all across the United States, so it's not worth much. Morning After is a 7-ounce beverage bottle from the Red Arrow Bottling Works in Detroit. It came off the west side on Martin Street. I got the privilege of going through the bottling plant, but I didn't find anything. It's a antique warehouse now, and some people feel like that little guy does after they get done drinking at the bar some nights. Mountain Dew was bottled by Pepsi, and they were bottled by Pepsi Cola all across Michigan in different cities. That particular bottle's from Detroit. Although the bottles weren't marked where they were bottled from, it was just on the caps. And that is the original contents. Mountain Valley comes from Detroit, and they were found in a bar downtown that had burned to the ground. These are what were in the basement. A few cases of them came out, and the varieties were mixed. There are four varieties known. The fourth variety is almost the same as the one on your far right, except the lettering on the back of the bottle is different. Mr. Pep comes to us from the Red Arrow Bottling Works in Detroit. Although it is not marked on the bottle, it is marked on the cap. And it's not a real common bottle. National Beverages comes from Saginaw, Michigan, and there are several varieties. I've only shown you a few, and they are still in business producing pop today. Knee High Beverages were bottled in all major cities. What I have here is shown as a 7, a 9, and a 12-ounce bottle. They're from Detroit, Flint, Grand Rapids, Jackson, Lansing, Traverse City, and Benton Harbor. They're a fairly common bottle. Just get on with that. Nesbitt's
is a real common pop bottle. It comes from Pontiac, Detroit, Mount Clemens, Adrian, Flat Rock, Saginaw, Ferndale, Escanaba, and Republic. I wouldn't pay more than a dollar for this one.
Nick's comes to us from
the 7-Up Bottling Company in Houghton and Ironwood, and it's a fairly common bottle in the UP.
North Star is a 12-ounce bottle,
comes from 7-Up Bottling Works in Cadillac, Michigan, the famous resort city. Northwestern comes to us from Calvia, Michigan. It's a 7-ounce red and white label bottle. New Grape is a real common bottle. Comes from Grand Rapids, Sault Ste. Marie, and Detroit, but it's most likely bottled all over the state. Russell Bottling had several different bottles. I've got them from all over the state. Benton Harbor, Muskegon, Detroit, Marysville, Grand Rapids, Kalamazoo, Clare, Sault Ste. Marie. As you can see, they had several different varieties. We have Old Colony, which comes from Benton Harbor, Michigan. There's only two varieties known, red and white labels. Old Standby is from Bay City, Michigan. It's a 7-ounce bottle, white and green label, and it's a fairly neat one. Get a real close picture for the label for you. Our leader is from Sturgis Bottling Works in Sturgis, Michigan. This is a pretty hot bottle because of the racehorses. Close up on the label for you. A lot of people like that. Plus, it's got that maroon and yellow color combination, which makes it unique. Milky's Party Time comes to us from Twin Pine Beverages in Detroit, Michigan. And it does have a picture of Milky the Clown. Most likely you would return this bottle to your local milkman according to what the back of the bottle says. Patio was bottled by Pepsi Cola all across Michigan, and it's real common. Paul's was bottled by Paul's Bottling Works of Casper, Michigan, and is a fairly common bottle. Peninsula was bottled in Iron Mountain, Michigan, by the Peninsular Bottle Company, and it is a fairly common bottle. As you know, Pepsi was bottled across Michigan, and the bottle at the far left is the oldest. There is a double dot between Pepsi and Cola, which means it's the older variation of the two. Then to the one on the far right would be the newest. Players was bottled by Red Rock Bottling Company of Flint, Michigan, and it's a 7-ounce bottle. This is kind of neat with sports collectors because of the different sports figures. Plymouth Rock Beverages was bottled by the Woodhouse Beverage Company in Grand Rapids, Michigan. Pomeroy's Beverage had several variations. It was bottled in Manistee, Michigan. I only have a few of the several variations.
Pop Shop was bottled in Port Huron, Michigan by the Pop Shop Bottling Company and is a fairly common bottle. As you can see, it's a little bit more fancier than the Hancock Bottling Works bottle from Hancock, Michigan. Quality beverages comes to us from the Coca-Cola Bottling Company of Alpena, Michigan. Red Arrow Beverages is from Detroit on Martin Street, and they had several variations. Red Rock Cola and Red Rock Beverages are the same company. I have them from Sault Ste. Marie, Adrian.